Hi friends, today we are going to discuss independent admission, admission of minor under Mental Health Care Act of 2017. I am Dr. Suresh Padadman, Professor of Psychiatry, Head of Telemedicine Center and Head of Forensic Psychiatry Unit at NIMHANS, Bangalore. Before I start my presentation, I would like to have a disclaimer. This presentation is for academic purpose only. And if you want to have a legal opinion, please do contact an advocate. Conflict of interest? None. This presentation is from the Mental Health Care Act of 2017. I am discussing independent admission and admission of a minor. There are two types of admission under Mental Health Care Act. One is independent admission, another one is supported admission. Independent admission is nothing but voluntary admission. Supported admission is nothing but involuntary admission. In this video, we are going to discuss only independent admission. Coming to the independent admission, again there are two types of independent admission. One for adult, which falls under Section 86, one for minor, which falls under Section 87. How we are going to discuss now one after the other. Section 85, the independent admission has been defined. The independent admission refers to the admission of a person with mental illness to a mental health establishment who has capacity to consent for treatment. So if the capacity is there, then he'll be considered as independent patient. However, Section 86 talks about the procedure. The procedure is the person under Section 86 should be an adult, need to have a mental illness, and he should have capacity to consent for treatment, and he will request for admission in Form C. This is how the procedure goes. Independent admission under Section 86 fills the form in Form C and requests for admission. Now the medical officer will decide on what are the circumstances he can admit. Please look at Form C. This is the Form C which is available under Mental Health Care Rights of Persons with Mental Illness Rules 2018. These forms will be made available in each mental health establishment and should be given free of cost. After filling this proforma, he will give it to the person who is in charge of the mental health establishment. Now, the medical officer, after receiving this application, and if he is, after the assessment, if he is satisfied, the person with mental illness who has given the application has severity requiring admission and is going to likely benefit by this admission and treatment, and he has capacity to consent for mental illness, and a person admitted as an independent patient shall be abiding by the rules of the establishment. Just because he is independent admission doesn't mean that he will not abide by the rules of the hospital. Consent will be taken by the patient only, not by any other person, and the presence of NR is not required. The patient can stay alone and the patient can discharge on his own. This is what is the crux of independent admission or voluntary admission under Mental Health Care Act. Moving on to the next one is admission of minor. Minor is any person below the age of 18. So that is comes under Section 87. Again here, in independent admission, that is admission of a minor, the parents or the NR or what we call it as a legal guardian will give an application in Form D. Once the Form D has been given, the person who is in charge of the mental health establishment has to do following things. This is again a Form D. The Form D is available under Mental Health Care Rules, Rights of Persons with Mental Illness section, under 2018. Once the NR fills this proforma and gives to the medical officer in charge, then following thing has to be done. After receiving the application, at least two psychiatrists should examine the child, or else one psychiatrist and one medical officer has to examine the child, or one psychiatrist and one mental health professional should examine the child, and the examination of this minor should be on the day of admission or within the precedence presiding 7 days before the admission. So within that period, if they have examined and issued an independent certificate that this child who has severe mental illness and the admission is in the best interest of the child and the child will benefit by this admission, and all community-based treatment has failed, and this is the only way we can help the child. And the child will be admitted in a separate children's ward. The child will not be mixed with the adult ward. However, many of my colleagues do ask, if there is a single room and it's a, what we call it as a general ward, and there is single rooms, in one room there is an adult patient, in another room it's a single room, the child, yes, it can be kept, but you're not going to keep the child in the adult ward, in a general ward where the adult patients are there. And very essential is, when the child is admitted, here NR is going to stay. That is nominated representative. If nominated representatives cannot stay, an attendant should be appointed to stay with the child. Suppose, if the child being a minor, that's basically if it is a female child, female NR will stay, or if there is male NR, a female attendant has to be appointed to stay with the child 24/7. For every treatment, nominated representative consent is must for admission, for treatment, for discharge. And within the admission of 72 hours, the person who is in charge of the mental health establishment should inform the mental health review board. At the same time, mental health review board shall or may review the admission or the records or interview the patient. However, the law has made mandatory review within 7 days if the child is admitted for more than 30 days in the mental health establishment. To conclude, my dear friends, independent patient means a person who has capacity and he will retain all his rights during his inpatient stay. But however, person with mental illness will follow the rules of the establishment, and the admission of minor will fall under section 87, and the nominated representative's consent is a must before you treat. This video will be discussing about supported admission under Mental Health Care Act of 2017. As you see the chart, there are two types of admission. One is independent admission, another one is supported admission. In this video, we are going to discuss about supported admission. As you see, supported admission have two types of supported admission. One is under section 89, up to 30 days. Section 90, beyond 30 days. In this video, again, we are focusing only on section 89. For section 90, I have made a separate video. Coming to section 89, admission up to 30 days. In this, an NR is going to give a request, basically an application, that is for me to the mental health establishment. That is to a person who is in charge, that is basically a medical officer. And this is the for me, how it looks. This for me is available in all mental health establishment and should be provided free of cost to persons with mental illness or to the NR. Once the medical officer receives this application, and if the patient fulfills this following criteria, he can be admitted. What are those criterias? The person needs to be examined on that day or in the past seven presiding day, or what you call it as presiding 7 days, he has to be examined by two people, either one psychiatrist and one mental health professional, or a psychiatrist and a medical practitioner. And both of them has to be examined independently, and both should conclude this person is going to benefit by admission. And further, he also has to fulfill these criterias. That is, the person with mental illness has recently threatened or attempted or is threatening or attempting to cause bodily harm to himself. That means harm to self is there, and it has to be recent, not past. Has recently behaved or behaving violently towards another person, or caused or is causing another person to fear of bodily harm from him. It's very complicated. It is simple, is dangerous to other, and it should be recent again. And has recently shown or is showing inability to care for himself, or to a degree that places the individual at risk of harm to self. So there are three important criteria: dangerous to self, dangerous to other, and he is unable to take care of himself, because of that he is harming himself. So if these three criteria are met, that means Section 89 can be applicable. Further, the psychiatrist and mental health professional or the registered medical practitioner should certify. Please do understand, they have to examine separately and should certify, and this is the least restrictive option available for admission and treatment under the circumstances, and the person has lost his capacity and he requires high support need. That means the person has lost his capacity and the NR is going to give the consent for treatment if there is no advance directive. Otherwise, advance directive has to be taken into consideration before starting the treatment. And the capacity assessment should be done every 7 days one. And if the patient regains capacity during the inpatient care, then advance directive and NR will cease. You have to take consent from the patient for further treatment or admission, and he can be shifted to Section 86 as a voluntary admission. And the admission under this clause will be only for 30 days. For more than 30 days, you have to invoke Section 90. Suppose you have admitted a person under Section 89 and he doesn't improve. Even after 28 or 29 days, now is the time you have to invoke Section 90. And request for MHRB has to be sent along with the informing that I am going to place him under Section 90. And also, he should not have capacity. At the same time, the NR has to give a consent for further continuation of the treatment. And MHRB needs to be informed within 72 hours for a female and 7 days if a person is a male. Dear friends, please do remember, in case the person with mental illness has been discharged and he needs to be readmitted, and if you are going to readmit within 7 days, it has to be under Section 90, not under Section 89. And if you needs to be readmitted, please do under Section 90. So today we are going to discuss here is supported admission beyond 30 days. In this, nominated representative will request for admission in Form F. And here again, what are the conditions which is required? If a person with mental illness who has been admitted under Section 89 and he continues to be symptomatic and he has lost his capacity and he cannot be discharged, then Section 90 will be applicable. By chance, if he had been discharged recently under Section 89 and within past 7 days, if you are going to readmit, you are not going to readmit under 89, you are going to admit under Section 90. And again, with these two important criteria, the NR should give an application under Form F. And the medical officer, after receiving the request, the two psychiatrists should examine him and to certify him that he fulfills the following criteria. This is Form F. The criteria is very clear. Two psychiatrists should have examined on the day of admission, or what we call it as in the presiding 7 days, they have to be examined independently, and independently has to be opined that he requires to be kept in the mental health establishment. For the criteria has, the person with mental illness has consistently over time threatened or attempted to cause bodily harm to himself. That is very essential. Consistently is trying to harm himself. And also, or has consistently over time behaved violently towards another person, or has consistently over time caused another person to fear of bodily harm. This is complex. Simple is, consistently is dangerous to others, or harm, causing harm to others. And also, has consistently over time shown an inability to care for himself to a degree that places himself an individual risk for harm to self. So my dear friends, the three important criteria, that is consistently is dangerous to self, consistently dangerous to others, and consistently is unable to take care of himself. So if these, in simple words, if you are able to understand, that means Section 90 is applicable. Along with this, the loss of capacity is must. And once you are admitting, you have to inform the Mental Health Review Board within 7 days if he is a male, or else if it is a female within 3 days. And Mental Health Review Board, if they are considering for Section 90, within 21 days, they have to report back and say, yes, continue with the admission, or else they can revoke the admission. At the same time, psychiatrist in charge of the treatment of such person with mental illness should submit a plan if the MHRB requires that after 90 days or under this section, what will be the community treatment plan. And one more important criteria, please do remember, merely there is no place to go for this person with mental illness. You cannot keep him in the mental hospitals. You have to discharge. And there are many instances Supreme Court has come heavily on the mental health establishment for keeping a person for 5 years, 10 years. And the reason is they don't have a place to go. That cannot be an indication. This Mental Health Act of 2017 bans that. And again, admission under this section. See, under this section, it is more than 30 days. Suppose, imagine, he requires for more days. For first instances, MHRB will give permission for 90 days. And even after 90 days, he needs to be inpatient. 120 days permission will be given. And if he requires further, 180 days will be repeated. But every time, MHRB should be informed. At the same time, the treatment will be as per the advance directives. If there is no advance directives, then if he requires 100% support, the nominated representative will give the consent. But if he doesn't have, he requires only some support, the person with mental illness will give the consent. Again, capacity to consent should be assessed every 15 days once. By chance, during the treatment under this section, if the person with mental illness regains capacity to consent, then advance directive and nominated representative will cease. Your admission and treatment will be as per the wish and will of the person with mental illness. That means with the consent of the patient. And Mental Health Review Board can review the admission. Coming to discharge, today's discussion is basically how the discharge of a person with mental illness from mental health establishment is done. There are two sections which is pertaining to it. Section 88, discharge of independent patients. Section 98, that is discharge planning. Coming to section 88, when a person wants to take discharge, that is independent patient, Form G will be filled by the patient and it will be handed over to the medical officer in charge. This is how this form will look. And these forms should be made available free of cost to persons with mental illness inside the mental health establishment. If the person is a child or a minor, the NR will fill the form H and will hand it over to the person, to the medical officer in charge for discharge. So if by chance with this, then the medical officer in charge will discharge the patient. However, by chance, if the minor during the admission becomes adult from 17, he becomes 18. Immediately, the medical officer will shift the patient from section 87 to 86. That is independent admission and he is an adult. And as per his choice, the admission will continue. However, the mental health professional or a psychiatrist can prevent a discharge of a person with mental illness from the independent admission and it can be kept for 24 hours for assessment. However, during this assessment, he has to observe that the person with mental illness who has been admitted independently has lost the mental capacity for treatment decision making. Then, one criteria, or else, he has recently threatened or attempted or is threatening or attempting to cause bodily harm to himself. That is basically dangerous to self. Or recently behaved or is behaving violently towards others or has caused or is causing another person to fear bodily harm from him. And in simple words, dangerous to others. Or showing an inability to care for himself to a degree that places the individual at risk for himself. So these are the three important criteria should be there along with loss of capacity. Then the person can be shifted to section 89. Or if the person has capacity and he wants to become under Section 86 as an independent patient, he will continue to stay. But however, the discharge planning is very essential. And this Section 98 will be applicable for all type of admission. What does Section 98 says? Whenever a person undergoing treatment for mental illness in a mental health establishment is to be discharged into the community or to a different establishment, the psychiatrist who is responsible for his providing care shall consult with person with mental illness or with the NR or with the family member or a caregiver, and he will plan for discharge. And at the same time, psychiatrist will ensure that a plan is developed as how to treat him or services shall be provided with the person with mental illness after discharge in the community or in the other establishment. And the discharge planning under this section will apply for all type of admission under this legislation. To conclude, my dear friends, discharge of an independent patient occurs under Section 88. And if an independent patient is asking for a discharge, please do discharge them. But however, if you think they cannot be discharged, you can hold for 24 hours for assessment. And then you please act accordingly. Either you have to discharge or else shift them for Section 89 admission. By chance, all admissions are there for both independent admission and also supported admission. Section 98, discharge planning has to be done. And if you like this video, please do subscribe to my channel. This is my channel, youtube.com/suresh padatmat. Thank you very much. Stay safe.